What's good YouTube, the Alfred here, and welcome back to another video. Today we're gonna be taking a look at cardio and why you don't need it in order to get lean. So sit back, relax and enjoy, because without any further ado we're gonna jump straight into the video. So a lot of people associate getting lean or dropping in weight or fat with cardio and with a lot of cardio. And that's not correct at all. In order for you to drop weight or drop fat, all you have to do is to get in a caloric deficit. You can do all the cardio that you want. You can do long-term cardio, HIIT, whatever the cardio that you want for as much as you want. But if you are not in a caloric deficit, you'll not be dropping weight. In order for you to get in a caloric deficit, you need to know how many calories do you need to eat daily. And if you don't know how many calories do you need daily, you can click on this link and that will get you to some of my videos explaining how you calculate your calories and your macros. And after that, you can calculate your own macros and calories and get in a caloric deficit. I myself have started my cut in the last month, and since I've started my cut, I have done cardio maybe 2 to 3 times at most, and I have already lost 1.5 kg with only 3 cardio sessions. Why? Because I've made my caloric deficit from my diet. And you must be questioning, then why all these people do cardio to lose fat or to drop weight? And they start to drop weight simply because they are already eating at the maintenance or just a little above maintenance calories. And by implementing cardio, the amount of calories that they will burn during the cardio sessions will put them in a caloric deficit. And that's how you should implement cardio in your workouts and in your nutrition. You should know how much you need to be eating and then implement cardio to help you achieve those caloric deficits. Because as I've told you previously, it doesn't matter if you are doing a lot of cardio, burning 300 calories per session, if your maintenance is, for example, 2000 calories and you are eating 3000 calories, you'll still be getting 2700 calories by the end of the day. And you'll be gaining weight because your maintenance is 2000 calories and you are eating 700 calories above that. So if you want to do it on the safe side, go for your maintenance in calories and then slowly implement some cardio so you can get on a caloric deficit. And then you have to choose what's the best approach for you. What's the best type of cardio for you? You have so many types of cardio and so many forms of doing it that you'll probably like at least one of them. I'm not a big fan of stationary cardio. I prefer to do some HIIT cardio, like some circuits, some sprints. But as I'm starting now my cut and my cardio isn't the most optimal at the moment, I have to start from the bottom. So I'm just doing some incline walk on the treadmill with around 4 to 5 in speed for around 20 minutes to start. And I will start to implement some more cardio sessions and increase the frequency and the intensity as my cut goes further. There will be a point where I cannot cut any further on calories. So I'll be forced to implement some more cardio and some more intensity cardio in my workout sessions so I can get a bigger deficit from it. Therefore, be able to keep losing fat. If you want me to do a specific video on cardio alone, like the methods of cardio that I like to do, the methods of cardio that are available for you to do, you can drop me a comment down below, say that you want it, and I'll be doing it on a near future. But for now, the discussion is only on whether or not you need cardio to lose body weight or body fat. So that's basically it for today. I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to drop me a like, also to consider subscribing so you don't miss my next video coming next week. Comment down below what I should do next. As always, thank you so much for watching and I hope to see you in the next.